I was just doing some reflecting on my conversation that I had recently with Seamus Clarke on the last two episodes of MindShift Podcast. One of the things that struck me about the conversation that was really highly ironic was, if you listen to part two, how he talked about people who need support and who need to be freed up from addictions and traumas, sexual abuse from their past. And he talked about finding a safe place, finding a place where you can be open, honest, transparent, where you can be yourself. And I thought, you know, he should be describing the church. This is what is supposed to happen, isn't it? This is the church. This is a place, ironically, that's supposed to be a safe, open, honest, transparent environment. But if you've been a part of the church, then you know that that's not the case at all for many, many churches. I'm sure there are some healthy churches out there. There might be. There must be. I hope there are. I really do. But the fact is, most churches are not places where you can be yourself. They're not places where you can be open, honest, and transparent. Because what happens is, you come in, let's say you become a Christian, you come in the church, and you've got all kinds of problems, you've got all kinds of issues, you're raw, as everyone else is, you've got trauma, you've got issues from your past and whatever. And what happens is, when people join churches, they're open, they're honest, and they quickly realize, though, that all the people around them seem to have all their shit together. They seem to be perfect, actually. And what happens is, these new Christians, over the years, they actually learn to wear the mask. They realize that, it seems like everybody else is perfect, everybody else has got everything together. I shouldn't talk about my problems and real life struggles and issues, because they look around, nobody else is. And so they go, well, I think that's the way church is supposed to be. And so they actually, the problems are still there, the issues are very much still there. The pastor, he or she, they never talk about their problems really, other than minor little things, you know, like, oh, I had a bad day, I was feeling a bit rough this morning, but you know, I prayed and now it's all better, I feel good. And that's the extent of the worst things that they ever confess from the pulpit. And nobody ever talks about the real life struggles, addictions, and problems that they have in their marriage or their family or whatever the case may be. And so they just learn to wear the mask. And what Seamus was actually advocating was that you, if you're deconstructing your Christian faith, you need to walk away from the church and find a place where you can do that. And one person commented on the podcast and said, where can I find such a place? She said, I'd love to find a supportive network. Where is it? But if it's not the church, where is it? And that's the whole point. That's the question. Where is it? I don't know. Maybe you have to create your own community. Maybe you have to find that place. You have to make it. You may need therapy. You may need counseling. You may need to find that place. But what strikes me, I was just talking on the phone with one of our Patreon supporters, Ray Guilford. In fact, we did a podcast episode back in December, Ray and I, on an overcommitment to biblical inerrancy and how the church has really, the conservative church coming out of fundamentalism, has majored on this doctrine of biblical inerrancy and where that's led the church and some of the core teachings that have come out around the Bible. And Ray mentioned that he understands that for many churches, God is a brand. God is a commodity, and that's what they're selling. It's like a salesperson selling a product. You have to sell this product, and that's what evangelism gets construed as. You go out and you sell God. And God has become this construct. God has become this commodity, this brand that it's being sold and marketed in these churches. And this is part of this whole system of what evangelicalism has become today. God is sold. God is marketed. And part of that is, as I say, learning to play the game and learning to wear the mask and learning to not only stuff your own problems way down inside, but actually, you got to go out and market this God that's supposed to be helping you with all your problems. Well, of course, God isn't really seeming to be helping anybody. You know, we just had this school shooting in Parkland, Florida on Wednesday. Was it Valentine's Day? You know, and again, we see the predictable cycle. Thoughts and prayers are offered up. and nothing seems to happen. God's not answering these prayers. These school shootings, these mass shootings in America just keep happening. Well, maybe God doesn't exist. Maybe he's up there waiting for us to get off our asses and do something about it. You know, so these are questions you have to think. If you're deconstructing your faith, what's going on here? Are you wearing the mask? Are you sitting in church going, man, I don't like the person that I'm becoming. I don't like the person. I don't even know who I am. But you got to question these things. You got to question this God, this marketed strategy that evangelicalism has come up with, the God of the liberal left or the God of the religious right. You know, Jesus, this hippie guru, or Jesus, this NRA-loving, gun-toting Republican. Is he a Democrat? Is he a Republican? Is God on our side? Is he on your side or my side? What are we doing here? And we have to question these things, and this is all part of the process. And hopefully, you can do that too. So I'd love to hear from you. If you have any thoughts or questions or comments on this, you can find me on Twitter at MindShift2018. You can also follow me on Instagram at MindShift Podcast. You can also send me an email, preachersforum@gmail.com, and also subscribe to the MindShift Podcast. We're going to be getting into next week, two weeks actually, a conversation with a friend of mine, Andrew Gurevich, who is actually a Jewish person, but he was a fundamentalist evangelical Christian. We went to Bible college and seminary together years and years ago, and then he left the faith. He became an angry atheist, speaking out against everything, and now he's kind of gone in this elliptical circle. He's more of he's into Paleolithic rock art, and he talks about religion, ancient spirituality, and goddess worship, and all these other things that are absolutely fascinating. So don't miss that coming up in the next couple of weeks with Andy Gurevich.